Chief Economic Advisor Arvind Subramaniam has presented the economic survey for the year to the Parliament, and he has strongly suggested that the economy is on a rebound. He's saying that for this fiscal, the economy may deliver a growth of 6.75% and 7.5% for the next fiscal. We have with us the Business Today team to discuss this. The editor of Business Today, Prosenjit, and Joe, my colleague again from Business Today. Let's start with you, Joe. Your initial response to the economic survey. The economy, he's saying that is back on track. First two quarters delivered 6.3 and 6.5%. If the year has to deliver 6.75%, we are actually expecting in the second half a much, much more significant growth than before.
Yeah, and his point is that the CSOs, the government estimate was that it would be, the growth would be in the range of 6.5. So by saying that it would be 6.75, he's showing that the it is a more optimistic picture is what he's showing. And the reason for that is indications that he gets from the GST collection so far, and also the other macro parameters, including the industry.
Direct tax collections as well have been quite robust. Bro, he's expecting at least 7.5% growth in the second quarter, in the second half.
He is expecting that. He's expecting a very sharp rebound in the next year, and more than that, he says that they are. In fact, he is predicting that there will be close to 8% in the medium term, and there are two interesting points that he made in the survey, which I thought was very, very pertinent. One was that he talked about the manufacturing, all the statistics showing a manufacturing rebound, and how it could lead to a manufacturing exports rebound.
Yeah.
Which, and with the imports also coming down. But more importantly, he pointed out that actually gross capital formation is going up, and private investment, he expects a sharp rebound, because he said that while bank credit has been low, the NBFC and corporate bonds and all have been almost 43% over and higher.
Yeah.
So that he is projecting a very sharp...
So the credit growth he has pointed out, yeah, very sharply.
He's predicting a sharp private investment credit growth and... Yeah,
so. In the medium term.
In the medium term. Yeah. And also, Joe, from the policy point of view, he's saying that the government doesn't need to do anything drastic. All it needs to do is to ensure that your twin balance sheet problem is taken care of, GST is implemented, and to surprise of many, he also talked about Air India disinvestment.
Yeah, essentially, what he's trying to say is that the steps that the government has been taking over the last 2 to 3 years has been in the right direction, and we are about to see the changes of those steps. But since the agenda is unfinished, he wants to go ahead and see that the steps that already have been initiated are reaching a logical conclusion. For instance, the twin balance sheet problem also, it depends on how fast they will be able to solve those issues. How fast the companies will be able to come out of the bankruptcy resolution. So, and the timely manner in which these things are.
So he made two points actually. One is that he said that look, the deed delay because of the IBC process, the NCLT resolutions that are taking place. The deleveraging of the corporate balance sheet is already taking place.
Yes.
Also, the recapitalization of the banks is taking care of the other problem. So his point is that that probably by the middle of next year, the twin balance sheet problem to a large extent will be sorted out or will be within control. So that is a.
But now, finally, to the three risks that he mentioned. One is, of course, this whole problem of crude oil price rise and how it is going to impact the current account deficit, and it could worsen for India. The second is the high stock market valuation, and he's saying that we need to be really vigilant about this. And third is, bro, the interest rates, the real interest rates that he's saying is a big cause for concern. Three issues.
Yeah, the real interest rate is a big cause for concern, but I don't know that what he can do, because the real interest rate is still, the RBI monetary policy is being very, very conservative.
Yeah.
And given the rate at which inflation is going up, though it's still moderate by the UPA standards, I don't see them reducing. In fact, there's an expectation that the RBI might actually increase the rates.
Yes.
The other two, I think, are to a certain extent control. I mean, oil also, there's not much that you can do about it.
Oil is beyond your control. And the stock market, the valuation is a factor of how much investment that is coming into the
country. But see, implicit is the understanding that, if the other asset classes like property and all start doing well again, then maybe some of the money will, which is now flowing into the stock markets, might go into real estate, which is what used to happen in the past.
And also, Joe, he's saying to remain extra vigilant about the stock asset prices.
Yes. I mean, essentially his point was that there is no need to be panic about the stock market rally. The thing is that the developments in India is not something exactly the same as we find globally. And one of the reasons, as you said, has been the great shift in domestic savings, which used to go in real estate and other savings, moving to the equity markets, which is one of the reasons for the rally. So his point was that you need to be eternally vigilant, because there can be a shock.
The only thing he was pessimistic about was the agriculture, which I thought
I think agriculture growth at 2.1% is still lower than 4.1% that would actually take us into some kind of a positive territory, whether this is concerned. With those were the highlights as far as the economic survey is concerned. Hope you enjoyed watching. Thanks so much for watching.
Thank you.